So you all are here for the master program, which is coming to an end, I believe, at the end of this year, June. But you're all from, well, not all, but you're from different places. Right. So what happens when the program is over? Are you all moving to Nigeria? Are you staying in Ghana? Are you going somewhere else, America?
So that's a good question. So that we haven't decided on what we'll do. As a team, we are more focused on building the product, because once we get a solid visa, we use a number of activities that are attractive to someone who might want to invest in us. It can help us make a decision as to where we want to be eventually. So we can't answer that question specifically, but we know that wherever we will be, we want to be in a market that there is a huge number of black women who will patronize our products and find value in our products. So be it in Nigeria, maybe in the US, or be it in Ghana, or anywhere else. Our focus will be close to our target market and also be providing value for them. So it's difficult to give that answer now because of our current focus, just trying to get the web up and build it to a point where we can make that decision.
It's good to know that you guys are open, because it's important to be flexible in where you're going. If it's like, I must be in Ghana, that limits your scope, but to be so open, I think would be beneficial to everybody, including me, as a Tress app user. So I guess my final question for you ladies would be, what is your favorite feature of the app? And to add to that question, compound it, what is your favorite feature that you've not yet released that is to come?
Okay,
yes, it
is. Oh, we three one by one. Okay. I'm going to say the favorite that has been released so far. That would be the trending tab on Tress. We have different tabs. We have the tab for all, for following and trending. Right. So the trending tab is the tab where you see all the feed that have been trending within the last 7 days. And it's amazing how, so people post a lot of hairstyles. And sometimes you get asked about, oh, the quality of the picture. But it's amazing how the trending tab filters itself. Like, the users on the app make the decision on what's trending. So it's interesting to see that, oh my god, people actually like this set of hairstyles. So if you come on Tress and you just go to the trend and you see the hairstyle that are popular within the last 7 days. That's my favorite. Yeah,
our stylist, who are our users, have asked us to build something like a salon page for them, so that would be different from any other user page, user profile. So they get to have their own salon page, so that they give out their much, like they give out much information about their salon, meaning their numbers, where the address of the salon and all those stuff, so that they feel like, okay, a salon page is different from a normal user page.
We actually have an interesting twist to the salon board. So it's not just going to be a feed of what the salon has posted. We want to give power to the users as well. So if you post an hairstyle and you tag the salon, that picture also goes to the salon's feed. So people can come on the salon feed and see user feedback and user hairstyle here on them. So it can just be hairstyles that the user posted.
So that means you could essentially put a hairstyle that was bad from the salon.
Yeah.
And then be like, well, this hairstyle's black.
Yeah, you can do that. So because that can potentially happen. Because a salon would definitely not post a bad picture about themselves. We want the app to be a community app, and for it to be as real as possible. So if a user posts both good and I don't want to look at it in the bad light. But then,
I mean, it's interesting though, from a user perspective, when you consider salons, because you don't want an environment where the salon only tells you the good stuff. So, like you said, you're building a community of feedback. By all means, you're going to get somebody who, you know, got their hair a little bit too fried or whatever, and wants an avenue to vent.
Yeah.
Which means that this app is different from other options for right now, because if I put something on Facebook, like a photo, let's say you post on somebody's Facebook page, it comes into a very little section on the side. But if I'm visualizing what you're saying correctly, it actually becomes a prominent feature of the salon's page.
Yeah, it's
like photos of you and photos of your hairstyles, so of you and your users who have used it and are sharing their hairstyles with you. So the two prominent features.
Yeah, I think that's pretty cool. So, thank you guys. I'm so excited. I don't even know what. Okay, let me just. Thank you guys for giving me your time. We're actually at Nest right now, on the incubator site, right?
Yes.
Right, so, we're gonna head out, and I'll put some more information in the description box. Ways you can contact these lovely ladies.
Yeah.
They also have a blog, right?
Yes, we do.
Please remind me. I think it's, no, I don't even want to get it wrong. What is your blog?
So we have blog.tress.co, and we recently started that on Tumblr. We recently started another one on Medium. That's just to feature salons and stylists and some of the hair hacks and hair tips we have for people. So different types of content. Yeah, two different blogs, different types of content.
So you
get blog Tress, Tress blog on Medium and blog.tress.co for the Tumblr blog.
So that stuff will be in the description right below. And you can follow them on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, everywhere. And you can download them in the Android store.
Yeah, Google Play Store.
The Android store, oh my gosh, I'm like 50. yes, in the Play Store. Soon to come on iPhone?
Yes.
Very soon. Thank you, baby.